The new Rich Solar Alpha 5 Pro batteries are pretty sexy, but does their upgraded design and features allow them to compete with our current favorite EG4 server rack batteries? So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Our experience with Rich Solar is hit and miss. Some stuff is really, really good. Some stuff, not so much. So when I first saw this thing and it looked as good as it looks, I was pretty fired up, but I was also ready to be let down. Thankfully, that was not the case. As always, we have some links down below and we were able to squeeze some discounts out of Shop Solar to get a discount on this guy. But before we get into everything that we like and don't like about this battery, we're gonna hit you with a super quick 60-second spec teardown in case you're not already familiar with the new Alpha 5 Pro. As you expected, the battery passes the Tiny Baby lift test, but it also passes the E7 standing desk lift test. So thank you to FlexiSpot for sponsoring today's video. As you guys know, sitting at your desk all day isn't necessarily good for you, especially if you have a bad back like Tiny Baby does from all of the lift tests. That's why we love the E7 standing desk from FlexiSpot. This desk is built to last. It's made with automotive grade steel and it can support up to 540 pounds. It has a massive range of height from the lowest setting all the way up to the highest setting. And if you ever want to take a break from standing or sitting, you can easily switch by just pressing one of the programmable buttons. And one of the best parts about this standing desk is that it's super affordable, especially considering the quality. Most other standing desks are about $1,000. And this one right here is only $499. Plus, you can get an additional $50 off with our code. These desks are backed by a free 30-day return and a 15-year warranty. So you can try one of these for yourself risk-free and buy one with peace of mind. So make sure you guys check out the link in the description down below. Use our coupon code to save 50 bucks. And thank you to FlexiSpot for sponsoring today's video. First up, this thing weighs 99.2 pounds, so it passes the Tiny Baby lift test. It's a 5,120 watt hour battery bank at 51.2 volts and 100 amp hours. The battery cells inside of this guy are UL recognized, and you can actually parallel up to 15 of these guys together and get a total of 76.8 kilowatt hours. On the front, you have a built-in breaker, you have two positive and two negative terminals, you have a ton of communication ports, you have your dry contacts, you got some dip switches, you got a button to turn on or off the BMS, and you have a nice little touchscreen actually. This is the most interactive touchscreen on a battery I have seen yet. And overall, this thing is just a much slimmer, sleeker. It has little vents on the side, extra handles on the side, which you don't normally see. And the price on this thing is $1,199 on Shop Solar's website. But if you start looking around, you'll realize that Rich Solar is doing the Rich Solar thing with this battery. And the price is like $1,799 on their website. It varies all over. So first up, we wanted to know how much this battery can actually handle in terms of surge. It's rated for 100 amps, so basically it's rated to run a 5,120 watt load. We ran 108-ish amps, so just over that amount of wattage on this battery. It basically did it for like 10 minutes. It only gave out because as it got really, really hot and the battery percentage was also really near the end, it started to creep up a little bit in the amps and it tripped itself out. But anything under basically 110 amps, this thing will just run. Like, it doesn't care, it just keeps going. As soon as you hit the 110 amp marker though, it basically just shuts itself off to protect itself, which is good news. It doesn't allow you to surge it like crazy, but it allows for a little bit of a mistake. We also wanted to go ahead and test the temperature settings on this. It says it's rated to charge from 0 to 60 degrees Celsius and discharge from negative 20 degrees Celsius to 65 degrees. So we went ahead and threw it in the deep freezer where it was a whopping negative 25 degrees Celsius. And as soon as you go ahead and turn this thing on, it just immediately protected itself. You could see we threw the charger in there, tried to put a charge into this, 0 amps was going in. We tried to run a load off this, nothing was happening. You go through the screen and you look and it's got the temperature protection lit up in red, telling you that, hey, it's protecting itself, it's not gonna work. And the last thing that we wanted to know was efficiency. All batteries should be about 100% efficient. The efficiency gets lost in your inverters and everything else. And this basically did exactly what we expected. We ran about a 90-ish watt load. It should have ran for about 1 hour and 6 minutes. It actually ran for about 1 hour and 5. So that's pretty good, that's like 99%. I wouldn't say there's a problem with that number at all. When you go ahead and peel the lid off this guy, it's actually really, really nicely built inside. There's an interesting bright yellow plastic shield over top, but when you go ahead and peel that off, Everything is assembled really, really nicely. The cage that holds all the battery cells in is actually screwed in through the side of the housing here. There is a flat, solid metal connector that goes from the positive terminal over to the top of the breaker. There's no big bulky wires, and everything in there just looks really, really dialed and clean. There's temperature sensors across the entire middle row to get kind of like an even temperature reading. And overall, everything in here was just really, really well put together. I didn't see anything that I didn't like or any weird problems going on in there. There is a few things that we didn't like about this battery though. And first up is just the price on Rich Solar's website. Rich Solar does this fun game. I think they want people to buy stuff from third parties or distributors or whatever. So like Shop Solar is a distributor of Rich Solar. They want you to buy it from there, not their website. So their website always has prices way higher than other places. But if you're someone like me, and you like doing the research directly from brands, you'll go to Rich Solar's site, see the price is astronomically high, and you'll just leave. You never find out that it's actually cheaper elsewhere. So that part always throws me off. In 2024, it's just starting to make me uncomfortable if people do this.
Transparency is that's what we want.
Just put it on your website and don't have any stock if you don't want people to buy it on your website. Put the price accurately. I also don't like that communication could be an issue with this battery. It doesn't communicate with any of the EG4 products that we had set up that we were trying to test it with. We had to run it as a lead acid. Obviously, it would work with all the Rich Solar inverters and stuff that we have, but that might be an issue depending on what you're trying to mix it with. You might want to double check what it can talk to. There is, though, actually a lot more things that we like about this little battery than things that we don't. I'm gonna say first up, this screen tells you so much information. It's a really, really easy to use touchscreen. Tells you literally everything. It's way more useful than any other battery's touchscreen that I have played with. The server rack cabinet for this is also so sick. We have an EG4 cabinet and it's pretty basic, bare bones stuff. You just slide your batteries in, hook them all up to your bus bars, you're good. This one, all four doors come off, all four sides. It's got a nice glass door on the front. It's got push-throughs, so you can put your wiring out the top, the sides, the bottom, the back, like wherever you want. It's overall, it's just a really sick cabinet, and I really like the feel of the whole cabinet and the whole product situation. It's a couple hundred bucks more than the EG4 cabinet, but it, to me, honestly, it feels justified. This thing performed really, really well, a lot better than some of the other server rack batteries we have tested out this year. And finally, Rich Solar, when you call them, you get someone in the US that gives you US customer support, which is hard to find. That's why we normally recommend you shop with someone like Shop Solar or Signature Solar, because they have US support. So at the end of the day, this thing's like 100 bucks cheaper than the EG4 LL with the screen. And at that price, I think it's a pretty damn good battery. It's slimmer, it's sleeker, it works really, really well. If you guys are kind of looking for something to compete in that range, honestly, I would recommend checking this thing out. We were pretty happy with them. We have some coupons for you down below if you want to use them. Otherwise, that's all we got for you guys. I'll catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.